Mr. Speaker, thank you. In these final hours of this year's tax season, Americans are finishing up their tax returns. For a majority of these taxpayers, it's painfully clear that our nation's tax system is deeply flawed and in need of significant reform. American workers are asked to work for 3 full months to fulfill their yearly federal, state, and local tax obligations. This is unacceptable. To require already stressed family budgets to force at least a quarter of their income to prop up expanding bureaucracy and increasing federal employment is just wrong. We are taught at a young age to work hard and that we will reap the benefits of hard work. Americans have witnessed that government is claiming more and more of those hard-earned benefits from the fruits of our labors. Instead of searching for a way to provide relief to American households, some officials within the administration have proposed new taxes that will further burden small businesses and consumers. The European-style value-added tax would levy a tax at each stage of manufacturing, thereby increasing the cost of the finished product. This is damaging not only to the consumer, but also to many industries involved in manufacturing production. I'm a member of the Anti-VAT Caucus. I recognize the dangers of imposing this new tax upon the American economy, and I've joined over a dozen of my colleagues in working to educate members of Congress on the problems posed by establishing a whole new series of taxes. Instead of adding new taxes, Congress should be focused on reforming the current tax structure. I've called upon the new chairman of the House Ways and Means Committee, the gentleman from Michigan, Mr. Levin, to schedule hearings on tax code simplification. The fair tax proposal was one of those ideas that I've asked his committee to consider. The fair tax can start the conversation on tax reform, and I encourage my colleagues who are serious about having this discussion to join me in contacting the chairman. People across the country are demanding that Congress listen to their concerns and find a more equitable and less burdensome way of paying taxes. I share their frustration and have called upon my colleagues in Congress to put the politics aside and provide tax relief and reform for this country. Americans have made it known that they are in need of serious tax reform. Through increased spending and budget deficits, Congress has awakened an American majority dedicated to government reform. Members of Congress have an obligation to be responsive to our people's needs. As the American people gather this week to make their voices heard, Congress must listen. These gatherings are occurring all over our country and here on Capitol Hill. In my home state of Kansas, these engaged citizens will be meeting in Mound City this evening, Kansas City, Hutchinson, Salina, Manhattan, Wamego, and Wichita tomorrow, and in Ottawa and Emporia will have meetings on Saturday. While these gatherings are occurring, millions of other Americans unable to attend will join in spirit to protest the expansion of government in our daily lives. As we approach the end of tax season, Congress must remember the sacrifices made by each American household. While this is the end of tax season, the rest of the year should be deemed the season of tax reform. The American people need relief, and Congress should respond. Jobs today and the health of the U.S. economy tomorrow demand our action. I yield back.